I'm Jason Snyder. I'm the Chief Technology Officer for Kraft Worldwide, which is part of McCann World Group. I oversee the global production platform and the networks that connect together about 20 studios all over the world for high-speed transactions in the production of video assets, audio assets, transcreation assets, and digital assets. So today, kind of the way that the platform exists is lots of different web portals with lots of different, what I would consider middleware components, and then all the data for those things are siloed. We have several petabytes in blob storage and sort of in different levels of blob storage as well. So some is in cold storage, some is hot, and we have years and years of video footage that people may be looking for. And inside of a single file, which may be massive, they may only need a small part of it. We really need to build a unified data model. And then we need to do all the data joins for financial data, HR data, and then of course all of the files that are associated with the work that people are doing across all these studios. So there's a lot of layers to it. All of World Group is part of the Microsoft 365 program, and we are deploying that across, 20-some thousand people. And, when we look at the different collaboration tools that would be available to us, it made so much sense to use Teams. And I think that the extensibility that's been built into Teams now in terms of the elegant way that we can surface really, really complex and deep information within the framework of the Teams interface itself is really the most valuable part of it. The first epic that we did was around index search and retrieval of the blob storage. And so that was the ability to locate, find, index through AI the video files primarily. So the idea is that within Teams we have we're leveraging the bot framework. And so anyone in any of the studios globally can go in and start to kind of interrogate or talk to the bot, have a conversation and say, look, I'm looking for these files that we worked on 2 years ago, or I'm looking for this one video that has the red pickup truck that was driving across at sunset. So that the using sort of the entire Azure cognitive set, right, and with the way that we've joined the data and sort of managed the indexing of the files, then the bot can return in a very elegant and simple way all of the information associated with that project, that file, that client, and it allows sort of the modal nature of the cards allows then that user to dig in deeper to find exactly what it is they're looking for. Using the bot framework with all the Azure AI and ML tools, it's a really cool experience. So, I've done lots of different scale business intelligence builds, right, and worked with many of Microsoft's competitors inside of this as well. And the way that the tools have availed themselves through DevOps, through the way that we've been able to partner with the cloud solution architects, the fact that we're participating in the Slate program, everything has just been really kind of lovely. So I think for me, it's like every day I'm learning more about what's possible. And a huge part of what we're doing is not just that product and that feature set that we talked about, but the network that supports it. And so within Azure and within Cosmos DB, we're able to actually implement some SD-WAN features and functionalities that help set the priorities for how the data moves around the world from studio to studio and through into that Teams framework. So getting that stuff wired up is really exciting. So like sort of the merger between the platform and the network. It's early days still. So we have a functioning prototype of some of the things I described. We're moving on to our next epics, which are really going to be more business focused. So we're looking at automating things like time tracking or travel and meeting requests and doing all of that through that same bot framework and within Teams, of course.